Hello, welcome back. So if you're new to this channel, I mostly make videos about lucid dreaming. And if you're new to that concept, the definition of a lucid dream is a dream in which the dreamer is aware that they're dreaming. So today I wanted to talk about the fact that lucid dreams are relatively rare. Most dreams are not lucid. There are people who rarely or never in their life have a lucid dream. And even for people such as myself, who have frequent lucid dreams, still most of my dreams are not lucid. And so we could ask ourselves, why? Why is that? Why are most of our dreams not lucid? In other words, why do we believe almost always these bizarre, strange, illogical hallucinations that we have every night? Some people always believe them. And I just wanted to pose that question of why and give some of my thoughts as to why it may be that most dreams we accept as real. So to begin, I think people don't tend to really question their own perceptions that often. We mostly operate under the assumption that reality is real. So outside of, say, a philosophy class or a really heavy discussion where you might want to think about whether or not things are real, you know, most people don't spend too much time thinking about that, or, you know, you'd be late for work. Or to put it in a more historical survivalist context, you know, if you're worrying about whether the tiger is real, you're going to get eaten. So mostly we just operate on an assumption that our perceptions are accurate, and in most contexts we just go forth believing that, most people, most of the time. Another example would be memory. Memory is not perfect. By any means, it's more of a story that we tell ourselves. It's imperfect, and every time you think about a memory, it morphs and changes a little bit. And most of us realize this at some point in our lives when we have a memory that differs from somebody else's, and most of the time, both parties really won't budge because it just... I think it's really scary to consider the possibility that your perceptions aren't real, that you're not remembering things correctly, or that maybe, you know, you're just having a little bit of a break from reality. That's a scary thing to confront, and I think most people just most of the time push that aside and just go about their daily lives. In a dream context, we could talk about what's going on in the brain to maybe investigate why most people most of the time, almost all of the time, believe their dreams. And so some of the information I'm getting about the neuroscience of dreaming is from this book called Lucid Dreaming, New Perspectives on Consciousness and Sleep. This is volume one of two pretty expensive volumes. I bought them online. I will give the full citation in the description below, but this was the only book I was able to find that gives a pretty good overview of the scientific information we have on lucid dreaming specifically. There are really not that many books at all on this topic in the English language that I found, and I'm really collecting a lot of them. So anyway, I'm going to read a little bit from the introduction of this book. Which says, neurological studies have shown how during dreams, the areas of the brain that are associated with executive functioning, volition, control, logical thought, are relatively disinhibited, while the emotional brain is more active than in waking life. In particular, a little structure called the amygdala goes into overdrive during dreaming, which is notable because this structure is known to mediate our fight or flight response. So, the reason I'm mentioning that, you think about these two things. We're saying that logical functioning, or executive functioning, logical thought, rational reasoning, things like that are less active. That part of your brain isn't, those parts of your brain are not working as well as they would when you're sleeping. And the amygdala, the emotional, one of the like emotion centers of the brain, is in overdrive. So you're even having a more emotional experience than you usually would when you're awake. And I think both of those are kind of a keys to posing an answer to this question, because to begin with, well, I have a bit of a hypothesis. I'm not sure if the fact that your executive functioning isn't really working when you're dreaming, when you're in REM, rational thought, linear logic, I don't know if that's the reason why the dreams are so bizarre, and or that's the reason why we don't realize that they're bizarre. I could see either or both of those things being true. But also, from my own experience, I think the latter part of this statement, the fact that the emotional brain is very, very active, the fight or flight response is being activated a lot during REM, I think that can really prevent you from realizing you're dreaming for the following reason. So I've been in this situation where I'm having a very emotional dream. Maybe it's a stress dream about work or a relationship, and it seems very important to me at the time, and I'm having a really strong emotional response, and I feel like there's a problem to be solved. And in that state, for some reason, something flags me to think, maybe this is a dream. But I feel very hesitant to even entertain that idea, because what if it's not a dream? This seems so important. Maybe I'm dreaming, but I have to take care of this problem. That's how it feels in the moment, because you're even more emotionally charged than you are when you're awake. So I think that can really get in the way of you even thinking about pausing and asking yourself if this is real, which is something I alluded to a little bit in my Why Learn to Lucid Dream video, which I'll also link in a card, because I mentioned that I think there's a connection here between dreaming and anxiety, like when you're having an anxious experience in your life and you maybe know that to some extent you're overreacting and things aren't really as real as they feel to you, but it's just the emotion is so strong that you can't even entertain that more logical reasoning because you're busy processing this emotion. And I think that that is also a big part of why, even if you don't even, it doesn't even occur to you, you might be dreaming. Maybe that's because you're just so caught up and so busy with the emotional experience you're having. And also maybe that's because the parts of your brain that deal with that rational, logical thought just aren't really working the way that they work when we're awake. So those are a couple of my basically arguments, hypotheses, thoughts on why most dreams aren't lucid. And these videos are going to keep coming out every Thursday, so if you hit subscribe, you'll keep seeing them. And remember that if you're trying to have lucid dreams or increase your lucid dreams, one easy way to do that is just to think about this concept as much as possible. So subscribing would be a pretty good idea. And thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.